Hey everyone, Alex here. 9 months ago, my college roommate asked me, hey, you want to do the Grand Traverse? And like an idiot, I said, sure, sign me up. What is a Grand Traverse? Well, it's a 37-mile ski mountaineering race up and down the Elk Mountains from Crested Butte, Colorado to Aspen, Colorado. This is the story of our training and our journey along the way. We'll see you at the top.
All right, good morning. Here we are, Grand Traverse training, 5:45, here at our home mountain in Elk, Vermont. What mountain you want to climb?
Mount
Ice. Yeah?
Say hi.
Hi. We can try. We live the adventure. Love the summer.
Follow the sun tonight. Got to my alma mater, the University of Vermont, and told them what we're doing. And because my teammate and I are both graduates and both alum, they said, hey, we'd love to be involved. And Sarah over at the Alumni Association was awesome. So she sent us a package of goodies and looking forward to showing what we got. So thanks to the University of Vermont. She wrote this really nice card here. She goes, Alex and team, good luck on your adventure and make sure to send us some photos. Go Cats. So Sarah, awesome. Thank you so much. Much appreciated. Let's see what's inside. Thank you so much, University of Vermont. Thank you so much. Go Cats, go. Let's do it. Bud Gillespie, like, how do you climb up the mountain? Like, and what do you, how do you achieve that without sliding back? So I'm gonna show you a little demo of how it works. So we have my special climbing skis, my uphill skis, and we have the skins that go on the bottom of it. And what they do is they attach with this little tip, this rubber tip here, and you can see on the bottom, it's a very sticky component to it. Now what that's gonna do is gonna stick on the bottom of the ski. So I'll take my ski, okay, and it's that slot at the top there. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna match up this tip, this rubber tip, hook it in here like so, then I'm gonna grip the bottom of the ski and you can see how it kind of just sticks right there. And I'll stick it right on, try to get it centered, okay? And then you can see how as the ski goes along, nice and smooth, then I stop and I push along and it's nice textured. And that helps me climb up the mountain. So that's kind of how it works. And when I'm all done, I just grab the top and then I pull it off, it comes right off. And that's how you climb up the mountain here. So I just showed you my skins and how that all works, but let's show you how the binding and the skis work. So this is a pin binding. It works with a special boot designed to receive the pins. You can see on the toe piece there. And of course the heel piece is specialized to receive the U-spring heel lock. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how you walk up the hill. You take your boot and you just line up your pins, okay? And you basically snap down with more force with your leg, okay? Okay, and that's how you would lock in, giving yourself the free motion. Now what you'd wanna do also is you'd want to rotate your back binding here. So you're now flat, okay? So as you're climbing, okay, and as you're moving, you're free touring, and let's say you're going up a hill and it gets steep, you can use your climbing aids like this. So now your boot is a little bit more level as you're climbing up the mountain, and let's say it gets even steeper, we can go one more, okay? And now your boot is level, but your ski is up on the tour, okay? So now we're going downhill, and what we would do is we put back our climbing aids. We would reverse the back binding here. Okay, and then, okay, and there we go. Now we're locked in, okay, ready to go in our downhill mode. Okay. We require certain skill.
And Lennon, what are you doing?
Training with Daddy.
You're training.
All right, we're gonna head out to see my training partner in Bend, Oregon, and do some training in the backcountry.
Garrett.
Go Cats, go. Here we are. I want to say thank you to our amazing wives, Christine and Garrett, Garrett's wife, Allie, our outstanding supporters of this endeavor. Liberty Mutual being our team sponsor. I'd also like to thank the University of Vermont Alumni Association and DiMillo's floating restaurant in Portland, Maine. As always, Garrett's looking real strong. Nice stride. All right, we'll see at the top.
Headed up Todd Lake. It's like mid-February. Doing some training with Borg in town. Carl's at home. I think he's getting a pedicure. Maybe a massage today. Trying to relax.
Go Cats, go!
In our final warm-up, final training up Crested Butte, here we are. Conditions are heavy snow. The course is, as of right now, open. It's a go. Avalanche Control is monitoring the current conditions and circumstances. But as of right now, race is on. We're excited. After this, be a good cool down, stretch. Tomorrow, full day of rest. And at midnight tomorrow night, we head out. So, wish us luck on the 2023 Grand Traverse. Team, go Cats, go! What do you say, Garrett?
Yeah, feeling the elevation.
All right, we'll see you at the top.
All right, we're at the top of Star Pass. And unfortunately, we were just notified that we missed the cutoff time. We started to ascend our journey up Star Pass. They gave us a 7 o'clock cutoff time. We are here at 6:50. And apparently Snow Safety decided to accelerate the cutoff time to 6:50. We're actually here at 6:47 and they cut us off. So we have to turn around and head back to Crested Butte. I'm pretty disappointed, as I'm sure you can understand, but this is the journey. We made it to the top of Star Pass. We missed it by -3 minutes, which is extremely disappointing and upsetting, but at least you can see the mountain behind. Hey Garrett, how are we doing today?
Hey, made it to the top of Star Pass. Pretty sweet. Beautiful, amazing.
Why aren't we going to Aspen?
They lied to us.
What time did they tell us?
Allie just said I thought turnaround was 7 a.m.
I know. What time did they tell us at the base?
Told us 7 a.m.
What time did it tell us at the summit?
6:50.
What a bunch of...
What time did we get here? 6:47.
6:47. Oh, gosh. It is a beautiful view. Skin of shame all the way back to Death Pass for the shuttle. Pretty beautiful though. Pretty nice view. What's it, Garrett?
We finished the race. 2 miles to go. We're almost done.
We're still gonna do like 33 miles today.